The next account is Ram Limited's account, and this is a customer. Customer is a debtor, and debtors are assets, and all assets have debit balance. That is the explanation, debit balance. Now let's try to justify this. Let's try to look at various kinds of transactions that a business could have with its customers. The first transaction would be a sale would be made. So let us say sale of goods, and this sale is going to be on credit. That's how a customer becomes a debtor. So the transaction is Ram Limited's account debit to sales account. This is the transaction for a credit sale. You are selling on credit and you are making Ram a debtor by giving him a debit. So let's say the amount is 100 and 100. Then you could recover this money from repayment by Ram Limited, so repayment by customer. And when you receive the payment, you're going to say cash account debit to Ram Limited, Ram Limited's account. And let's say you receive 90 out of that. You could also receive full money, but you know, he's not going to pay you more than 100, of course. Now, if you post these two transactions in Ram Limited's account, so Ram Limited's account, the first transaction you will write two sales, credit sales taking place, 100, and then the second transaction you write on the credit side by cash, 90. Okay, now in this case, if these were the only two transactions, you have a debit balance. Total of debit side is higher than the total of credit side. And I just said the customer is at best going to pay you 100. He will not pay you more than 100, of course. So you will never have a credit balance. You will never have more amount on the credit side. Now you could argue that there can be multiple transactions. Well, you can do multiple transactions. You sold more goods to Ram, so sales. Another sale of 500. And then what is going to happen? He's going to pay you back. When he pays you back, you are going to write by cash. What if he pays you through bank? Well, you write by bank. And how much is he going to pay you? He's going to pay you 500. At best, he will pay the previous 10 as well, and you will write 510. Okay? Still, there is no credit balance. You can have no balance in this account. Of course, any account can have no balance. But the debtor's account here cannot have a credit balance. The total of the credit side cannot be higher than the total of the debit side for an asset account, for a debtor account. That is my point. Now, let us say the customer does not pay you 510. The customer only pays you 500 and then says, you know, I can't pay you the remaining 10. It becomes a bad debt. What happens in that case? When there is a bad debt, the journal entry is bad debt account debit. This is a loss. All incomes and losses are debit. So bad debt account debit 10 to the debtor's account, and debtor's name is Ram Limited account. Now what do? You go to the credit side because Ram Limited's account is being credited, and you write by bad debts and you write 10. Now again, there is zero balance in this account, but you can never have the total of the credit side going higher than the total of debit side. So again, I have tried to provide you justification on why a debtor's account cannot have a credit balance. It will always have a debit balance, or at best there will be no balance. Let us look at another account, which is a vendor's account in this case. All vendors are liabilities. This is a liability account. All liability accounts have a credit balance. This is exact opposite of the debtor's account, and I'm going to show you how. So let us say this is Rahul Limited's account. What is the journal entry when you purchase from your vendor? When you purchase from the vendor, the journal entry is purchase account debit to the vendor's account. Vendor's name is Rahul Limited. Rahul Limited's account, 100 and 100. Now, what is the next transaction? You could purchase more or you could pay back. Let us say you pay back. When you pay to the vendor, then the vendor is the receiver. So you debit the vendor's account, Rahul Limited's account debit, to cash. Cash is being paid to the vendor. How much are you going to pay? You will pay 50, you will pay 90, you will pay 100, but not more than 100. Let's say again you pay 90. And now let me bring these two transactions into the ledger account. So purchase debit to Rahul. So we're going to write buy purchase account here, 100. And the second transaction, Rahul debit to cash. So to cash account, 90. What is the balance? Credit total is higher than the debit total. 100 is greater than 90. This account has a credit balance. All right. Now you could say that you paid 100, in which case the account will the balance will be nil in the account. Could you pay more than 100? You will not pay more than 100. You could argue saying we could pay more than 100, and then in the next purchase that we do, the vendor can adjust the account. Well, if you pay more than 100, then this, you know, that amount is not shown here. That amount is an advance given to a vendor that becomes an asset. So that is not shown in a liability account. So that's altogether a separate transaction. When you hand out an advance to your vendor, that is your asset. That is, you know, not shown under the liability. That's not an actual payment which is shown here. All right. So let's say, you know, even if you become, if you pay, 100, you will have, balance higher on this side. So all the purchase is going to keep accumulated on the credit side, and all the payments are going to accumulate on the debit side. So this is what is going to happen at the best. Now, one more transaction which could possibly be here is, you decide that you are not going to pay to the vendor, in which case you don't necessarily do anything. Payment of remaining 10, it will keep standing in your balance sheet as an outstanding, as a liability, as a creditor. But the bad debts adjustment is done in the books of, Rahul Limited. So you don't have to worry about that side. So as far as your company is concerned, you only do purchase transactions here and the cash received on the other side. Let's move on to another account. This is salaries account. Salaries account is an expense and all expenses have debit balance. Why would this happen? Now, what is the transaction relating to salary that happens in a business? Business pays salaries. That's all. Business does not receive any salaries. The only transaction that happens is business has paid salaries or business has not paid the salaries which have become due. So let me write the journal entries for those two. When you pay salaries, the transaction is salaries account debit to, let's say, bank account. And if you do not pay, you still recognize this as an expense, but rather than accounting it in the bank account, you say outstanding salaries. Outstanding salaries account. So 100 and 100. These are the two possible transactions relating to salaries. And when we pay salaries account, when we prepare salaries account, we are going to write on the debit side to bank account, you paid 100, and to outstanding salaries account, 100. So you didn't pay it in cash, but it's a liability. So, either both the transactions are going to be recorded on the debit side. There is going to be actually nothing on the opposite side. So the account is always going to have a debit balance. The total on the debit side is going to be higher than the total on the credit side. And this is going to be true for all the expenses. Therefore, there should not be any doubt going further that the expenses are always going to have a debit balance in the ledger account. Let us look at bad debt. Bad debt is a loss. All expenses and losses are going to have a debit balance. We did not talk about losses having a debit balance, but that's going to be addressed now. So when a bad debt takes place, the journal entry is bad debt account debit to the debtor, to debtor's account. Okay, so let's say this is the amount, it is being debited, you're going to write this on debit side, to debtors 10. Now at best, you know, what could happen is you could recover the bad debts, in which case you are going to say cash account debit to bad debts recovered account. But mind you, this is a new account. This is not same as the bad debts account. So bad debts recovered is going to be a new account. So the only transaction that is going to be in the bad debts account is going to be on the debit side. Whenever somebody does not pay you, you transfer it here. And the total on the debit side is going to be higher than the total on the credit side. So always a debit balance. So all expenses and losses are going to have a debit balance.